Happy morning, children. Welcome to Blue Stars High Secondary School online classes. Today you have your class for English. Okay. Before getting into this class, let me give you the thought for the day. You will never understand the damage you did to other person until the same is done to you, isn't it? So we should not do any harm to anyone. Okay. So because one day that will revert back to us. So we have to be good as you can. Now today we are going to see the unit 4 prose. Okay, we have already seen the poem, the ant and the cricket. So today we are just going to see the unit 4 prose. Okay, the name is the attic. What is an attic? Yeah, attic is the extended part in the room, okay, of the wall in the rooms where we used to keep all the things, okay, the unwanted things we used to keep in the attic, the loft, okay. So before getting into that, we'll just see some glossary. So see here, bifurcated. Bifurcated means divided into two. Revive, to bring something back to life. Soothing, make someone feel calm. Rustic. Rustic is typically of a countryside. Okay, a person who lives in countryside, he looks rustic, we say. Dilated, widened than usual. Sorry, ascertained. Ascertained is confirmed. Overwrought. Overwrought, a state of being upset. Attic. Attic, the space or room at the top of a building under the roof. Crumbled. Crumbled is broken. Okay. Spire. Spire is a tall pointed structure on top of a building. Normally the church tower and all. Okay, it's a spire. Unperturbed is undisturbed. Affluent, wealthy. Smacks, drive or put forcefully into something. Okay. So this poem, prose, the lesson, the attic, is written by Satyajit Ray. He is a famous Indian filmmaker, screenwriter and a graphic artist, music composer and author. Okay. He was born in Kolkata. He authored several short stories and novels meant primarily for young children and teenagers. He revived the children's magazine Sandesh. Okay, his grandfather actually started the magazine. And he was an editor in that until his death in 1992. Ray was more interested in writing rather than filmmaking. His stories have been translated in Europe, the United States and many other countries. Ray received many awards, including 32 National Film Awards by the Government of India, notably the Padma Bhushan in 1965 and the highest civilian honor, Bharat Ratna, shortly before his death. Okay, so he was also, there are many films of Satyajit Ray. So this is one of the writers of Satyajit Ray. So the attic, this is your fourth unit, children. Satyajit Ray. Okay, the attic by Satyajit Ray. So this, in this lesson, we have some characters. Okay, so Aditya we have, and his friend, and then just see here, we have one person who is working in a tea shop. Okay, we'll just come across all the characters in this lesson. Okay. So the narrator is just telling this poem, sorry, the lesson. Okay, Aditya and I were returning from the site of our new factory at Deodarganj. So here it is, the narrator is telling the story. So Aditya and I, so the narrator and Aditya was returning from Deodarganj, okay, from the new factory. So they were just driving in the highways, okay. When they reached the point where the road bifurcated, where the road divided into two, we drove 10 kilometers along the road that branched off to the right. We would reach Brahmapur. Understood? So they were just driving along the National Highway. Okay, National Highway 40. That is the road which they are driving. At one point, the road was divided into two ways. Okay, if they take the right side of the road, if they drive along 10 kilometers, they will reach the Brahmapur. Okay, So I asked Aditya whether he was interested in revisiting the place of his birth. Okay, Brahmapur was the place where Aditya was born. So the narrator was asking Aditya whether he is interested to go back to have a look at the place where he was born. Okay. Yeah. I asked Aditya whether he was interested in revisiting the place of his birth, which he had left after he had passed the matriculation examination from the local school to continue his studies in Calcutta. Understood? So after the matriculation school, okay, after the school life, Aditya has moved to Kolkata, okay, for his higher education. So now he is also owning a factory. And Aditya, the narrator, was just returning back from Deodarganj, and they were just traveling in the National Highway 40. So they came to a point where the road is divided into two. And if you take the right side of the road, you can reach Brahmapur. Brahmapur is the place where Aditya was born and brought up as a boy. He was born in Brahmapur, and he did all his schoolings in Brahmapur only. From there, he completed his school, okay, matriculation examination from the local school. Local school means school at Brahmapur. After that, to continue his studies, he has moved to Calcutta. So the narrator is asking whether we can go back and have a look at the place where we were born, that is Brahmapur. Okay, so see here. The ancestral, next to ancestral house, 29 years ago, the house was almost 200 years old. So what is this? How much old is the house? Yeah, it is 200 years old. Okay, when I left our ancestral house 29 years ago, the house was almost 200 years old, recollected Aditya. So in the Brahmapur, they have their ancestral home. Ancestral houses where their great-grandfather and the grandfather used to live. Okay. So when I left our house, which means it was almost 200 years old when I left. Just imagine, when he was a boy, he left the city, isn't it? During that time itself, the house was 200 years old house. Okay. I doubt if even the school building, which may have undergone many changes, will be recognizable anymore. Okay, trying to revive childhood memories may prove disappointing. So what is it? Normally we feel happy when we just look back the place where the house we lived, the school we studied. But here something is disappointing him. Okay, that we are missing those things. We may not be go back and learn there. Okay, so see here, during when Aditya was a young boy, how much old is the house? It is a 200 years old house. So even that school building, okay, they have studied here long back, okay, and 29 years ago. By this time, the school building also would have undergone many changes. Okay. So he was just trying to recollect all his childhood memories, and he was a little disappointing over that. But he said he wished to visit the tea shop of Nagin uncle, if it still existed, and have a cup of tea there. Because this is the place, the tea shop, Nagin's tea shop is a favorite place where they used to have the cup of tea. So we took the right turn into the right and decided to drive to Brahmapur, of which Aditya's ancestors were once the zamindars. Okay, so Aditya belongs to a zamindari family. So now, in the narrator asked Aditya whether we can go to Brahmapur to see the house and the school. And though Aditya was a little bit disappointed, he wished to have a cup of tea in Nagin's uncle's shop. So he said, yes, we can go there. Okay, because once upon a time, Aditya's ancestors, they were the zamindars in the Brahmapur. Understood? See here, Aditya's father had left the ancestral home and moved to Kolkata, where he had set up his own business. Okay, After his death, Aditya was looking after it, and I was his friend and business partner. So the narrator is telling, when Aditya came to Kolkata, when he was young, after finishing the school, isn't it? So Aditya's father, he has come to Kolkata to set up his own business. Okay, so after the death of the father, obviously Aditya was looking care of the business. Understood? So the narrator was his friend and a business partner. It was the month of Magha, that is January to February, in the mid of January. By the English calendar, the middle of winter, isn't it? So during this time, it will neither too hot nor too cold. By my watch, it was 3:30 in the afternoon. So what is the timing? Yeah, the afternoon 3:30. The sun was soothing, so which means the sun is not too hot or no sunny at all, isn't it? On either side of the road were paddy fields as far as the eye could see. See how much pleasant the view should be. The sun is also very soothing, and on both sides of the road they have only the paddy fields. As far as they could see only the paddy field. Harvest was over and there had been a good crop that year. After about 10 minutes, we came to the local school. Beyond the iron gates were the playing field and this two-story school building. We got down from the car and stood in front of the gate. So now where they have come? They have reached the school where they were studying, where Aditya was studying. Okay. Yeah. So now the school has its iron gates. So when you just cross the iron gates, there will be a play area. Okay. And the building is just two-story, two-floor building. So now the narrator and Aditya just got out from the car and they were just standing in front of the gate. Which gate? School gate. Okay. I asked Aditya whether everything was still the same. He replied that everything had changed. So the narrator is asking Aditya whether the school is the same or it is a different one. It has undergone any changes. The narrator is asking to Aditya. So Aditya says everything is changed because our school used to be a one story, that is one floor building, and a new building has come up which wasn't there. Now it is a two story building, but initially it was just a one story building. Now a new building was come on the top of the first floor. Okay. You were very not a good student, I asked. Yes. But my position was always second, he replied. Okay, so the author is asking whether you are a good student. And Aditya says, yes, I am. But I will be always in number two position. We decided to go and have a tea at Nagin's uncle tea shop, which stood next to the grocery shop and opposite a temple dedicated to Lord Shiva. So where is this Nagin's uncle's tea shop? It is next to the grocery shop and opposite to the Shiva temple. Okay. Soon we caught sight of Nagin's tea cabin written on a signboard over the shop. So what is the name of the shop? Nagin's tea cabin. So the author and the Aditya are going to the Nagin's tea cabin to have a tea. See, the owner of the tea shop now over 60, a little rustic in appearance, with his white, neatly combed hair and clean look was the same as before. Okay, so he's looking the same, just like only he's becoming little aged. Other than that, all the features remains the same. Okay, he was wearing a dhoti and a blue striped shirt that could be seen from under a green shawl. Okay, so what is he wearing? He's wearing a dhoti and a blue striped shirt. Okay. But can he recognize Aditya? Because Aditya has grown now. He would have seen him when he was a young boy. Now he has grown into a man, isn't it? So he could not recognize. Nagin was not recognizing Aditya. Not recognizing Aditya, he asked us where we had come from. So Deodarganj, Aditya replied, we are on our way to Kolkata. So he is telling that we are going to Kolkata. So meanwhile, we came here to have a cup of tea. So a little surprised, Nagin uncle asked why we were there. To have a tea at your shop, said Aditya. Certainly, besides tea, I have biscuits and savories. So he was very much surprised because they are on the way to Kolkata. They are coming here to have a tea. So Nagin was asking, so do you have, what do you want? What else do you want? They said, so Nagin is telling, besides tea, I have some eatables also, some biscuits and some savories I have. So Aditya is telling, I would like to have two Nankatai each. Nankatai is a type of sweet, okay? It's a famous Indian sweet, okay? And it is a popular in India and Pakistan. We sat on two tin chairs. There was only one customer sitting at the corner table, okay? Other than these two, who is sitting? One more person was sitting at the corner table. He was not drinking tea. But he was just bending down his head like he was sleeping. Okay, so he just Nagin was calling that man who was sitting in the and sleeping in the bench of the tea shop. He says, Mr. Sanyal. Okay, what is he calling him? Mr. Sanyal. Nagin uncle reminded him to go home. So what is it? So Nagin is asking the man to go home because it is already 4 o'clock. Okay, now all the customers will start to come. So better please go home. Why he is asking him to go home? He is just lying down and he is just sleeping here, though he is not having any tea. So addressing as he said with a wink in his eyes. See, a little hard of hearing, cannot see well either, but has no money to buy spectacles. So once the tea shop owner. Who was tea shop owner? Nagin. Okay. So he was telling Sanyal, Mr. Sanyal, to go home. Okay. On hearing that, what one should do? Either they should get up or they should go home. But this Sanyal was talking irrelevantly. He is telling, I could not hear properly. I cannot see well. Okay. I has no money also to buy any spectacles. So from this reaction, okay, the narrator was wondering whether he is a crazy fellow or what. And immediately after saying this, I cannot see well, I cannot hear well, I have no money to buy spectacles, Sanyal just get up from the place where he was lying down and he was just stretching himself. No, when you are just waking up from the sleep, you will just stretch yourself, right? Just like that, he was also stretching himself and he was reciting a poem by Tagore, Panraksha. Okay, Panraksha is keeping of a promise. He is just reciting a poem. Having recited the poem, he left the place making the gesture of namaste with his hands to nobody in particular. So which means generally he was just telling namaste. Okay, he was not pointing anybody, either Aditya or the narrator or Nagin. Generally he was just giving one namaste to all. And he was just reciting this, Tagore's poem, okay, and he just left the place. So see here, I noticed a sudden change in Aditya's expression and I asked him for the reason for it. Without answering me, he asked Nagin uncle who the gentleman was and what he did, okay. So immediately after listening to the poem recited by Sanyal, the author was just observing something, some change in Aditya's face. Okay, so Aditya was not answering to the author, but he was asking Nagin, like, who is the person? So Nagin also said that it is Sasanka Sanyal. What can be done? He leads a cursed life. So what has happened? What happened to Sasanka Sanyal? See, he has gone crazy, I think, but has not forgotten any incident of the past. Okay. He is crazy only, but he has not forgotten any incident of the past. Sold his lands to get his only daughter married. He lost his wife and son only last year. Since then, he is somewhat changed, not really normal. So what Nagin is telling to Aditya? Yes, he was good only, but he sold his land for getting his daughter married and he also lost his wife and the only son. Okay, last year only he lost his wife and the son. From then on, he becomes somewhat abnormal. Okay, and Aditya is asking, where does he stay? Okay, so Nagan's telling, he stays with his friend of his father's, Jogesh Kaviraj. Okay, where Sasanka Sanyal is staying along with the father's friend, Jogesh Kaviraj. Sasanka come here, has tea and biscuits and always remembers to pay. Though he is crazy, just see, he will always pay for what he is eating. Having an acute sense of self-respect. But how long things will remain like this, I don't know. Okay, so as of now, he is very good. He is paying for what he is eating. But I don't know about what will happen in the future. Nagin was telling this to Aditya. Having paid a bill and ascertained the location of Jogesh Kaviraj's house, we got into the car. Aditya was at the wheel. Okay, he expressed the wish to visit his house. So now, initially when the narrator asked whether we can go and see the house at Brahmapur, Aditya was not much interested. He just want to have a tea in the Nagin's shop. But now, he is very much eager to go to the ancestral house. Okay. So now the narrator is asking, why do you want to go to the house? Okay. So Aditya says, I have some important work to do. Okay. So that is why I want to go to my house. So we soon reached the house, which was surrounded by high walls. Even from the ruins, one could easily imagine how grand it must have been once upon a time. So they are going to the house after 29 years, isn't it? Now it is almost damaged. But on seeing even that damaged house itself, one could imagine how grand that house would have been in those days. We entered the building, climbed up the stairs and reached the attic on the second floor of the house. Okay, so where is the attic? Second floor of the house. This was my favorite room, said Aditya. The attic has always been a favorite with children, isn't it? So usually children used to keep all the things in the attic. So it is the attic that the child seems to be in the world of its own. Okay, so like just like other children, Aditya also likes to keep everything. Whatever he owns, he used to save it in the attic. A portion of a wall of the attic had crumbled down and through the window that had been created. What is this window? It was broken. From that we can just see the outside world. We could see the sky, the fields and a part of rice mill, the spire of the old temple. In the whole house, the attic had probably been the worst hit by wind and weather because it was so long years. So it has undergone many changes. Even the attic has also damaged. The floor was strewn with twigs and straw and the pigeons' droppings. Okay, the dirt, it was so dirty. Among other things, there was a broken cricket bat, the remains of an armchair and a wooden packing case. So these are the things that are in the attic. Aditya got on top of the packing case and pushed his hand inside the ventilator, thus upsetting a sparrow's nest. Okay, so he was just trying to find something in the attic. By that time, he just upset a sparrow's nest which was built there. A part of which fell to the ground also. However, he heaved a sigh of relief when he had got what he had been looking for. So he was just finding something, isn't it? In that finding process only, he has just upset a sparrow's nest. Okay. So the narrator was asking to Aditya, what are you doing? Okay. So the Aditya says, wait, you will come to know it soon. Now, they just went to a jeweler. Okay, they had just find out a medal. Okay, they find out a medal. Okay, so they just went to a jeweler and they were just asking for the jeweler whether he can give money for this medal. The jeweler says it is an antique piece. Okay, so he has just given some 150 rupees to Aditya. Then getting that money, they went to the Jogesh Kaviraj. Though I was a little curious, I didn't ask Aditya anything. We entered the house and went to the room where Sasanka Sanya stayed. Sasanka uncle was busy reciting verses from Tagore. When he had finished, Aditya asked, "May we come in?" He turned and faced us. So now Aditya is going to visit home. Sasanka Sanyal, "Why did you see here?" "No one visits me," he said in an unperturbed manner, "because so far no one have come to visit Sasanka Sanyal because he has lost his wife and son. After that, he also become little crazy. So nobody will come and visit him, isn't it?" So when Aditya and the narrator was asking him, "Can we come in?" he was telling, "No one will visit me. Would you mind if we come in?" So the Aditya is asking, "Come in." Except for a carpoy, there was nothing else to sit down. So we were remained standing. So they were standing, okay. "Do you remember Aditya Narayan and Chaudhary?" Aditya asked him. So Aditya is asking whether you remember Aditya Narayan and Chaudhary is the full name of Aditya. "Of course," said the gentleman, "the spoiled child of affluent parents." So what is affluent parent? The parents whom are very rich. Okay, they are just a spoiled child of affluent parent. "Was a fairly good student but never beat me." Okay, so they both, Sasanka Sanyal and this boy, that Aditya, they both were studying together in the school. Okay. The Sasanka Sanyal was telling, "He is a good boy, but he could not beat me." Because once Aditya was telling to the narrator, "No, I always stood second in the school." So the first one who stood first was Sasanka Sanyal. And he is telling, "Yeah, he was extremely jealous of me." Okay, because of the jealousy, he used to tell lies. "I know," said Aditya. Then he took out a packet from his pocket and handing it over to him. "This is for you," from Aditya. "What is it?" he asked. "Money." "Money? How much?" 150 rupees. He has said that it will be happy if you accept it. So what is happening? Aditya is giving the money to Sasanka Sanyal. And he is telling, "This is given by Aditya. Aditya told to give this money to you." Okay, now Sasanka is telling, "Whether shall I laugh or cry? Aditya has given me money. Why the sudden generosity?" So he is just very sarcastic. Okay, Sasanka Sanyal is telling us sarcastically, "He is normally not a good boy during the school days, but now he is giving me money. Why sudden change?" Okay, so Aditya says, "Man used to change with time." So that change happens to Aditya also. That is why he is giving you the money. Okay, "A change. I got the prize. He could not beat it. He took it from me to show his father and never returned it to me. He said that there was a hole in his pocket and it has fallen through it." So what is telling? Once Aditya said that you have this money with you, Sasanka Sanyal was telling, "No, I got the prize." Okay, "I got the prize for reciting the poem." Okay, so Aditya has taken this medal from me and he told me that he want to show it to the father, but he didn't even return that medal to me. He says that there was a hole in the pocket and the medal has fallen through the hole. When Sasanka says this, Aditya was telling, "This is the price of your medal. It's yours." Sasanka Sanyal was amazed. He stared at Aditya and said, "So I don't want the prize of the medal. I want the medal only." Okay. So he's telling it is a silver medal. So he says silver is now 30 times costlier than before. That is why you have this 150 rupees. So really, I had no news of that. But Sasanka uncle looked at the 10 rupees note in his hand and then looked at Aditya. There was completely new expression on his face. He said, "Aditya, this smacks too much of charity, doesn't it?" So Sasanka was addressing him straight away. "So you are trying to be more generous. Why are you giving this money to me?" We remained silent. So now Sasanka Sanyal has found out that the person is Aditya. But the real thing is, he has recognized him even at the Nag and Sankal tea shop itself. There was a mole in the right cheek of Aditya. What is mole? Yeah, it's a macham. Yeah, he has a mole on the right cheek of Aditya. On seeing that, Sasanka Sanyal recognized that it was Aditya. That is why he recited a poem at Nagin Sankal tea shop, no? Yeah, the same poem which he recited when he was a young boy, for what he got the prize. Okay. And now, you have done the right thing. Your grievances are absolutely justified. But I'll be happy if you accept the money. Sasanka Sanyal shook his head and said, no, money will soon be spent. So what do you want? I want only the medal which I won during my childhood. Okay. So now they just went back and got the medal. So the medal which was hidden in the attic for 29 long years was given back to Sasanka Sanyal, because he was the one who won the medal. Aditya just lied to this Sasanka Sanyal that the medal was lost. But finally, he had his medal back. So what is written on the medal? Sriman Sasanka Sanyal, special prize for recitation during 1948, was still clearly engraved on it. Okay. So this was from a Bengali story, Chilikota. So I hope you understand the lesson, children. So read the lesson. After watching the video, you have to read the lesson and just check whether you understand each and every line. After that, learn the synonyms and antonyms and learn the question answers paragraph, and then write it down in your classwork note as a practice. Okay. Thank you, children. Have a blessed day.